Hello there, this is Captain Ghostly, level 7. I'm making this video to show people how to play poker on GLOPO. This is my character. Looks pretty nice. I do think so myself. So when I first made this video, I came in here with 3,000 ghosts. I didn't start it off with that though, I didn't start the video off when I first came in, so. But today I'm going to be showing you guys how to play poker, because I know some people don't know how to play. They just come in and sit down and bet. And a lot of people complain, say they lose a lot when they play it. So, let's get started, shall we? Alright, now the key to this game is to spin, it's to bet as less money as you can unless you have a good hand. Like right now I have an ace and a four. High ace is, it's an alright hand, but as you can see, there's a jace, five and a two. There's really nothing good about my hand right now, so I folded. He had a five, a pair of fives, so he won. There's no reason for me to go ahead and bet. Alright, I have an ace and a six. I'm gonna go ahead and check. So I wanna see what cards come on the table before I get down and bet. I have another high ace, and I don't have any pairs, so I don't really want to bet. So I'm going to go ahead and fold, because I'm pretty sure one of the other two players right there, the other computer players, but pretty sure one of them have an actual card out, a pair of queens. Now if I would have stayed in that because that ace came out, I probably would have won that, but there's no reason to chance spending money out on the table if you don't actually know you have something there. Alright, I have an 8 and a 3, a high queen, no pairs. Now see how I check? I check because I don't have any pairs on the table. I have a high queen that's really not going to give me anywhere for real. There's no reason to bet money if you don't actually have a pair or a flush or a straight. You're just going to lose your money basically. He has a pair of jacks. What do you want? Now pairs aren't the top play cards on here. The top play cards on here is a full house. If you get a full house or something, then you should bet on it. I have a 10 and a 2. I have a pair of 10s, queen kicker. So I'm going to go ahead and call this time, because I do have a pair. But if they have a queen, then they're going to beat me. Oh, wait, I folded. Okay, I folded. I'll go ahead and fold. As you see, I'm using bandit.com. I don't know how to get the actual voice chat on there while I play. So what I do is I record me playing, and then I go back over it with audio city. But I came in here with 3,000, and I left with a pretty good amount of money. So you can make a lot of money if you know what you're doing. Now I have an ace and a ten. Now if there's another ace on the table, then I will win it if they don't have a king or anything higher than a ten. But there's no ace on the table right now. But I have straight to the queen. So I'm a bet for this. Because that's actually a pretty good hand. Hopefully they don't have straight to a queen with a higher than that 10, but I doubt it. Straight to the 8. Oh yeah, I'm definitely going to win this one, so I'm going to bet as much as I can. See, what you do is you bet to make them put money on the table. If you bet, then they can't take. So that's the beginning of the round. And there you go. I just won $1,500. This game is to no win to bet, no win not to bet, and no win to fold. Like me, I don't bet if I don't have any of the cards thrown. If a dealer hasn't thrown any of the cards on the table, I don't bet. I always check. And if they bet, which makes me have to bet, then I fold because I don't know what's going to come out. I want to actually see what cards are laying on the table before I actually make a bet to make my chances better. Right now I have a pair of eight queen figures. There's a nine on the table, so if he has a nine, then he's likely to beat me. Or if he has a queen or a king, he's likely to beat me. But he folded, so, you know, I won that. I like that too, because if you have a low hand, if you play it through by checking and they don't make you bet money, then you still have that option to win if they fold, even though they could have beat you because you had a low hand. See, I don't like these hijacks. Like, anytime I get like queen high, those are iffy to play. So I usually fold on those hands. And right now I can tell you if any of them have a pair of 10, then that's the person that's most likely going to win. Or the pair of queens. Or if they have a flush. Or straight out. See, he had an 8 with a 10. See, the 8 and 10. Basically, you want to have a pair, or basically, this is the order of how it goes. The highest card, or the highest hand you can have, is a full house. I'm pretty sure y'all should know that. After the full house, it's straight. Whatever straight. After straight, it's four of a kind, I think. Then three of a kind. Wait, let me go back up. Full house, then flush, then straight, then four of a kind, three of a kind, then pairs, then the queen high or king high or whatever. You have a pair of kings and an eight. And right now the king is not the highest on the table, because a jack beats the king. Yes, in this game a jack beats the king. But I have a king and I have an eight, which means, you know, I don't have